and spend time with Him. Yeah. You know, before anything else, just spend time with Him and say thank you. I don't know what to say. Say thank you.
Yes.
He paid a price we could never pay. Amen. And we don't get it. We could never pay. So say thank you. Amen. And He wants to bless you at all times. I wanted to read this to you on a daily basis. I put a scripture break, and it kind of goes with this song and the song service. But the scripture break says this: Holy Spirit will lead you. The Word and the Holy Spirit will tell you what to do. Make adjustments in your life that will keep you from the dark world from overtaking you. The key to overcoming the flesh is walking in the Spirit. Your flesh will try to dominate you with pressure. Mm-hmm. Follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. Follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And you won't be overtaken. Right. Learn to follow the Holy Spirit's lead. Yes. He will guide you safely around the traps and the pressures the devil has laid for you. Mm-hmm. And the Holy Spirit wants to lead you to victory.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. He wants to lead you to victory. Yeah. God has called us. God has called us and put us on a mission and has equipped us to fulfill our mission. He's called us to be champions. He's called us to be winners.
Yes.
But we need to make the adjustments so that we can be in tune with Him.
Amen.
You know, a radio out of tune is annoying, but when you tune it up, it sounds good. Awesome things coming from that radio.
Yes.
We need to be in tune with Him on a daily basis, constantly adjusting our GPS and hooking up with Him, because He wants to lead every one of us, not just somebody. Well, you know, this person is more special than this person. No, He's not. Remember, we've talked about this. You are God's child.
Yes.
Special. Amen. So see yourself the way He sees you.
Amen.
And when you spend time with Him, put your love and compassion glasses on as you go into the world. Because the world is not nice. The world is not nice. Amen.
Yeah.
So remember that. So I just want to read that to you and welcome you to all of you, those of you that are joining us through audio or video. We welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend.
Amen.
In the Big Bend area in Marfa, Texas. Amen. So we welcome you. Prepare yourselves to receive. We have an awesome guest speaker today. He's a friend. He's a minister. He's a writer. He is awesome. And God used him in a mighty way. Amen.
Amen.
So without any ado, we just want to welcome our friend and mighty minister of God,
amen,
servant of God, Oscar Cobos. So come on up, Oscar.
Thank you, brother. Bless you, sir.
It's an honor to be here today. The Oscar, house of God.
Give, turn the mic on. Oh. Yes.
I've got my pilot certificate already.
Okay.
It's an honor to be here today to give all the glory to God, because He deserves it.
Yes.
There is so much going on, and things can get pretty ugly out there, but we serve an awesome God, a beautiful God in every way. And I'll tell you one thing. Last week I had mentioned to you all about a message that the Lord had given me, titled The Essence of the Presence. And I really praise God for that, because I share an example that I'm going to share with you this morning. Quiero compartir este ejemplo, if I may. I'm going to be ministering in both languages this morning, and it's an honor. I really want to thank all of you for the invitation here, Pastor Jose and Patricia and everyone. It is an honor, because right here today, we're fixing to share some ammunition for such a time as this.
Yes,
every believer should know about warfare, spiritual warfare, and know about the rules of engagement for warfare. Because, you know, God says we believe to believe in Him, but to live for Him as well. See, there's going to be situations that are going to be rising up against us, so we better know to be in tune with the Spirit of God, to be in tune with the ammunition to fire back at that lying horrible looking enemy.
That's right.
For such a time as this, he wants to come against our families. Él quiere venir contra las familias, contra la iglesia y contra la nación. He wants to come against this nation every day with his tactics, but there is power in the blood of the Lamb.
Yes.
Hay poder en la sangre de Cristo. El mensaje este día se titula La Esencia de la Presencia. And I was reading this, and I, you know, the Lord just has something for all of us.
Yes.
You know, there were several years back that I wanted to, you know, just stop and just say, well, this is enough for the jail ministry. I've done 6 years ministering at the jail, the Bristol County Jail. And I said, well, I guess I'm fixing to take up somewhere and do this and do that. And that's what the Lord is going to do with each and every one of us. When we start to walk out that door, cuando comenzamos a salir por la puerta, en nuestras propias decisiones, dice, Señor, ¿dónde crees que vas? God is saying, where do you think you're going?
That's right.
So this weekend, it's an honor to be here because this is my 7.5 years with the county jail in Alpine. He pulled me back and said, no way, you come back in here, you continue to minister.
Amen.
Okay, God will give God the glory for everything that is doing. A Dios sea la gloria por todo lo que está haciendo y va a seguir haciendo. Y di un mensaje, di un comentario nomás la semana pasada, gracias a nuestros hermanos. Bro, thank God for a brother and sister and everyone here. I shared about the relationship last week. I just commented a little bit on the message about as the Spirit leads this morning, we're going to go into this message, what He has to say for me, for all of us.
Amen.
In general. What we need, lo que se necesitamos más. Y había comparado esa relación con el matrimonio. I had compared the relationship with a matrimony, with, you know, with marriage. Because there are those situations at times that arise. And I gave this example about this woman that was one of my co-workers going through a situation. She was at Dallas and we were in this job. And she said, Oscar, this is going on and that's going on. And I'm not seeing him at all. He's in his own world. He gets home and he's not, seems like he's not there at all. And it's just like, and she was just in tears. And you know, at times some things come out pretty blunt. It was like, oh my God, did we just hear that? And I need to be told that too. Because the Word of God is like a double-edged sword.
Yes.
Sometimes we're going to go like, oh my God, did I just hear that? But see, it's for our own good. It's the discipline and the power of the Holy Spirit. La disciplina y el poder de la palabra y el Espíritu de Dios para que seamos testimonio, that we may be a testimony to a world out there that is losing traction on a lot of things, a world that doesn't know how to respond with the situations, with the attacks of the enemy. And I shared with this woman, she said, this is going on and that's going on. And I just came out and I said, oh my God. I said, tell me. She said, tell me. And I was like, I don't know, she caught me off guard or something. I was stocking some shelves at the grocery store. And I said, you know what? I believe that you're no longer in a relationship. You're in a refrigerator. I'm like, oh my God. And then later in the afternoon, she looked at me and I was like, oh my God, did I hurt her feelings? But no, you know, see, the church in general, the relationship with God has to be on fire for God.
Yeah.
Has to be on fire for God. We're in a covenant relationship. Estamos en un pacto con Dios. Porque el enemigo quisiera tenernos en ese hielero, en ese refrigerador. See, the enemy would want to keep us in there. That we're not hearing from God and we're not talking to God. Then there's a cold draft blowing us like, oh my God, what's going on here? My hands are getting cold. Well, see, if I don't stay in the prayer, in the fasting, in the Word of God, si no me quedo en la palabra y bajo la dirección del Espíritu Santo, es muy posible que vaya a dar en esos pensamientos. It's possible that I end up in those thoughts, in those opinions of the world that are out there. And boy, there's a lot of opinion, and more opinion. But then there's the power of the living God. Hay el poder de Dios que se está manifestando poderosamente. Porque ahorita, right now, speaking in general, in a lot of cases, it's easy to slip into those areas that nothing's happening. You know, I was thinking of something when I was reading the Big Bang Sentinel and I was visiting with Bob Harper in the paper. I said, you know, go ahead, would you do me a favor and insert that in there? I noticed, because I can really appreciate your paper, every word, cada palabra tiene poder. Every Every word has so much power. Every word, the spoken word that comes out of our mouth, the written word has so much power. And if you notice, every event that is done in Alpine, that is done in Marfa, that is done all over the place, because it's pretty well put down. So the church needs to go to that level of understanding, that level of flowing in the Spirit, that every word that we write, every word that comes out of our mouth, be so powerful that the church will put it in first gear and say, okay, here we go now. Yes, porque es posible que el enemigo quisiera tenernos con temor. The enemy would want to put us in fear and say, oh, well, wait a minute, you can't say that. And I always like to use the example also of Job, and I might have shared it last time. A lot of times we don't want to say nothing to Job because Job is a big giver. We don't want to step on Job's toes. Oh no, we don't want to step on his toes. He those beautiful big offerings and this, but guess what? Job has an addiction. Job needs God in his life. He might be a big giver. Dios, este hombre, José, tal vez que no lo queremos ofender, no queremos pisar en los dedos bordes de sus pies con las palabras, pero vamos a tener que. Porque José necesita liberación. Necesita el poder de Dios. Job needs the power of God in his life. Whether big giver, small giver, Job needs the power of the Spirit, the deliverance. He needs the word in his life.
Amen.
I'll tell you one thing, ministering in the jail has been quite an experience for me because I munch on that message. I have to. Me tengo que alimentar con el mensaje de la cárcel también diariamente porque también me enfrento a acechanzas. I am confronted by the attacks of the enemy, by situations, and so much. But I'll tell you one thing, you know what I tell the men at the jail? Y ¿sabes qué les digo a los que están presos en la cárcel? Entré ahí la primera vez que entré hace como, pues hace 7 años y medio. Me dice el carcelero, ¿qué quieres? ¿Quieres que traiga a todos los que están presos? The detention officer, you want me to bring them all? I said, bring them all in. And there were 52 men. And I'm like, oh my God, I said, better make sense right here. He said, no, let it be you. Let it be your words. Flow. So I tell the men what I tell you today, and I have to tell myself, what do you want to do today? You want to cry or you want to pray? Because real men cry and real men pray.
Yeah.
Real women will cry and real women will pray for such a time as this.
Yeah.
And it's all right. It's all right if you got to start crying right now. Go for it. The healing power of God is what we need. We need His therapy for such a time as this. Right now, we need it so much, even more. I'll tell you one thing. I had shared with you all that my daughter had joined the armed forces, and I was like, oh my God. And you know, when you mentioned this morning about doom and gloom, I said, oh my God. And I cried like a little boy in the middle of the night, and I was wide awake. But you know what God is telling me? He pulls me by the ear, and He said, you're moving from fear to faith. From fear to faith. We tenemos que venirnos el temor a la fe diariamente. Every day from fear to faith, and declare the blood of the Lamb over her and over all those that are in the armed forces.
Yes.
And over the families.
Yes.
Declarar y decretar el poder de Dios sobre todos. La sangre de Cristo tiene poder. There's power in the blood of the Lamb.
Yeah.
You know, I was looking at that message, that word, you know, just came out, essence. And it's really something because there's so much power in every word. See, if you go in the Hebrew and Greek translations, you'll see there's so much in depth, there's so much meat in the word, so much substance.
Yes.
See, I can stand up here and I can do this and do that, but if the Spirit is not flowing, if I'm not going as the Spirit leads, that word will not, it'll just be so much theology and this and that, it could be cut and dry. There needs to be that the Spirit to give it substance.
Yes.
In depth. To bring deliverance.
Amen.
To bring the word of prophecy, to bring a word of discernment, of revelation, and of interpretation. Que Dios traiga la palabra de interpretación, de discernimiento, y de liberación. See, this is the mighty God that we serve. Ese es el Dios que servimos. You know, I always like to share, and I tell the man, and I have to tell myself, I say, you know, I'm not sitting on top of a cloud. We're all on here. We're all down here, and we got to move in the authority of the Spirit, and we can, you know, this is, I like to look at things from a spiritual perspective. I don't like the word look at the things from a religious perspective, because it seems like it's A plus B equals C, and out the door. When the Spirit of God is moving, cuando el Espíritu de Dios se está manifestando, es de lo natural a lo supernatural, from the natural to the supernatural. See, because we need deliverance, we need healing. With whatever we need, God knows, and He says, delight yourself in the Lord, and He will grant you the desires of your heart. Dice, deleítate en Jehová, y Él concederá los deseos de tu corazón. Grande y poderoso es Jesús. Y sigue siendo diariamente. Y this is, you know, I saw this and I won't read it all, the definition of essence. In philosophy, essence is a property or set of properties that make an entity or substance what it fundamentally is and which it has by necessity, and without it loses its identity. And this really powerful, you know, that word just came up. I said, oh my God. See, even the word has to flow under the direction of the Spirit. La palabra tiene que fluir bajo la unción del Espíritu Santo. Si no, if not, it's just going to be cut and dry. I can just go blah, 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 this and that. It's like, oh my God, what was that all about? You know, and under the direction and the anointing of the Spirit, especially right now. It's like going into a restaurant and, oh my God, and people go, yes. And that's what I mean. When we go to a restaurant, we say, Lord, there better be some quality food. And there's places sometimes, we go to some of those places and, you know, some of those restaurants, like, oh my God, do I have to pay for this? You know, and it's very important that we be in the prayer, in the fasting, and in the word, and that every word, just like the Marfa paper and everything else, we're going to ride at the beauty of those words and the power of those words, and all over, just flow. Let it minister to our heart, let it minister to our spirit, and our mind, and every way, because these are serious times.
Yes.
And He's a mighty God, you know. When we get in tune with the Spirit of God, it's like, oh my God. I do believe that for every man, and I tell the men at the jail, le digo a los hombres en la cárcel, le digo, mira, dile que te enseñe. I tell the man, you know, just show him, you know, because, see, the strategy of the enemy has been to derail the purpose of a man in the home.
Yeah.
And in the church, and in the nation.
Mm-hmm.
But God's original purpose to the word is that the man will be raised up in the home, the church, and the nation in positions of leadership or whatever. And see, many might not think this, but the gospel, I always like to share this, that the gospel goes inside the halls of justice, into our councils of government, and all the way through the ivory towers of education. He has to go. Because the moment we put him in the box, el momento que ponemos a Dios en unas cuatro paredes, dice el enemigo, ahí los tengo. Son conformistas. Then we're conformists. Only within the walls of the church, and that's it. Oh, no, you can't say anything out there. And you know what happens? Sometimes, you know, that's really a religious perspective of things, but God wants us to move in a mighty way. And you know, when I mentioned, Pastor Jose mentioned about writing, there's areas that I write that I'm like, oh my God, you know, and I said, Lord, it'd be you. Because there's certain areas of oppression that are coming on the people, whether it be social, economic, whatever, but God is saying, write these words and only that. You know, and it's, so God is telling you as a man or you as a woman, you feel like writing this, you feel like going into City Hall, going into the highways and hedges, flow in the Spirit.
Yes,
amen. Stand in the gap.
Yes.
And que Dios te dirija para el tiempo como hoy, porque el poder de Dios está dispuesto. Y en este mensaje, in this message today, I'll tell you one thing, I'll mention it, you know, because it's, I'll tell you, that's the God that we serve. He has a spiritual buffet for us here.
Yes.
Tiene un buffet tremendo, de alimento tremendo para el tiempo como hoy, porque necesitamos un movimiento del Espíritu. en nuestras vidas y en nuestros familiares y en este lugar de Marfa, de Alpine y en la nación y en toda nación. Because we need a move of God in Alpine, in Marfa, all over the region and over the nation and all nations. So what is he going to take? Ammunition. He's going to take the rules of engagement, and it is going to take to rise up and say, no way. No way, we serve a mighty God, and we're not going to put up with that. He's going to take the prayer and the fasting. Gloria a Dios por su palabra. En el libro de Isaías, the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, and verse 1, here we serve an awesome God. Yes. He's moving in a mighty way, I'll tell you. In a mighty way, I shared, Pastor Jose, Patricia, know that I went through areas in my life, went through depression in 90, and praise be to God that he was there. Amen. The word is Jehovah Shammah. Yeah. That God is there. And I went through the area of separation and divorce, and God is there. In every way, raising two girls as a single parent for 11 years, God is so awesome. Yeah. Had I gone off that way, things might have gone wacko. If we start to enter our own opinion and our own ideas, but God is saying, no. Let me help you with this. Let me give you the strength that you need. Yeah. Let me put a hedge of protection over your home and over your children. Yeah. And he has been awesome. They're really awesome. In chapter 61, in the book of Isaiah, the libro of Isaías, the word of God says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good things, good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Amen. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God. To conform, to comfort all that mourn. Yes. To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion. To give unto them beauty for ashes. The oil of joy for mourning, and the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Hallelujah. And it's all right to say hallelujah.
Yes.
It's all right to say hallelujah this morning.
Yes. Hallelujah.
To glow in the spirit. Because the enemy will want to keep us like old raggedy Andy there in the corner. I like to use the term just full of cotton or whatever, just... Praise be to God that he wants us to flow in the Spirit.
Yes, yes,
el Espíritu de Jehová, del Señor, está sobre mí, porque me ungió Jehová. Vea, él dice, me ha enviado a predicar buenas nuevas a los abatidos, a vendar a los quebrantados de corazón, a publicar libertad a los cautivos, y a los presos, apertura de la cárcel, a proclamar el año de la buena voluntad de Jehová y el día de la venganza del Dios nuestro, y a consolar a todos los enlutados, y ordenar que los afligidos de Sion se les dé gloria en lugar de ceniza, oleo de gozo en lugar de luto, manto de alegría en lugar del espíritu angustiado. See, God is just transforming lives day after day after day for those that are willing. You know, there's an old saying of an old quote from, I'm trying to think of his name, and I always tell the men at the jail, and it's really something in that. I'll think of the author here in a minute. He says, if you feel like you're going through hell, don't stay in it.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Amen.
See, many of us have gotten comfortable. Many of us have gotten comfortable. There's people that have gotten comfortable living within the church atmosphere and say, well, and I told them at the jail, unless you've gotten comfortable there, and they're like, oh my God, and it's over. We came to court to get comfortable because the enemy will say, I've got it in that corner,
yeah.
In a corner of defeat and depression, and it's just horrible. And I'll tell you one thing, when I went through the area of depression, I said, no way. You know, there were all sorts of opinions, you know, counselors, which God can move through counselors in every way. Then I had to say, wait a minute, whoa. I had to say, God, you know, what really helped me was, do not fear, for I am with you.
Yes.
Do not be dismayed, for I am thy God, I will strengthen you.
Yes.
Lo que muchos me ayudó en el tiempo de presión, dice, no temas, no desmayes, que yo soy tu Dios, que te esfuerzo. Y grande y poderoso es Dios en todo, que sigue haciendo cosas grandes y milagrosas. See, in that beauty for ashes, there are several things that are going to have to go in our lives. In order to get in tune with God day after day. Because the enemy's strategy is to cover our ears with the opinion of the world, with all these wall ideas that are floating out there. You know, all these concepts. Todos estos conceptos que empapan los oídos del hombre. All that wax that is built up as a spirit, so worldly waxes, is like, all of a sudden you can't even hear the word of God because we're so in tune. And I always like to say we're in tune. There's a fascination for intellectualism. And nothing bad with being an intellectual. But is the spirit flowing? Is the word, is God being glorified in this? Nada mal contra la inteligencia, pero mucha gente está fascinada con la inteligencia. They're like, oh my God, wow, that's an awesome speaker with his all this intellectualism. Whoopie-doo. Then we come out and say, what was that all about? See, the word of God says, la palabra de Dios dice que no, que son como noria sin agua, nubes sin lluvia. At the end of the day, there were big clouds without rain and wells without water.
Oh yeah.
And this happens every day. See, the moment we get in tune, I like to say, to look at the Word of God from a spiritual perspective, to be guided by the Spirit of God, to flow in the Spirit of God, to be let the anointing come forth like fresh fire, then we're going to start to see everything in living color, and we're going to have to have discernment into those areas that God has taken us into. Dios nos va a dar discernimiento. Comienza a revelar todo poderosamente. He starts to reveal those things in our homes, in our own personal lives, in our marriages, in our jobs, and he pulls us by the ear and says, don't go in there. I don't want you to deal with that person right now at all. Or he gives you that prompting like, yes, you tell him straight up about the mighty God that he needs in his life. Dile directamente del Dios que necesita. Del Dios que necesita. I was there at Porter's working several years back. And a lot of you all have seen the deli there in Alpine. And I was on break. And I went to go and get me my lunch. And there was a guy standing there. And many of you might have seen him here in town and seen him all over the place. With the uniforms of the universe. Yeah, they take the welcome mats and all over. And this is the God that we serve. Perfect God. God of perfection. The Holy Spirit starts to reveal. Comienza el Espíritu Santo a revelar todo. And I'm fixing to get my lunch, and he turns and looks at me. And I felt this prompting of the Spirit just speak to him. I'm like, oh my God. See, in the natural, we're like, no way, I don't even know him. It's going to freak out everybody, as they say. They're going to go, like, oh, wait a minute. Why is this guy running his mouth? This guy doesn't even know you. But the Spirit of God prompted me and said, let him know. And I told him straight out. I said, and he says, hello. And I said, hello. I said, you know what God is saying? And he looked at me. There's several there waiting for the lunch. That it is time that you follow your wife in the direction that is in him. It is time that you support her in his direction. It is time that you go the way that she's going. It is time that you move on in the marriage and support your wife in the direction that she's in my direction. Oh, and that's the mighty God that we serve. Had it not been done in the supernatural, in my own way of thinking or whatever, he would have turned around and said, who the heck are you? I'm not even married. See, el Espíritu de Dios le habló este hombre. Y ese día en El Paso, en Horizon City, he delivers all over the area. Y le habló directamente. Dijo, es tiempo que persigas tu esposa en mi dirección. Que la apoyes para el tiempo como hoy. Es tiempo que estés ahí respaldándola en la dirección que va en mí. Y ese es el Dios perfecto que servimos. See, he starts to reveal everything in every way. Because there's a transformation process going on right now, individually and corporately. When we allow the Spirit of God to flow. And this man, he goes in tears. And like I said, you know, that's the mighty God that we serve. I want that God, the living God, to point out those areas in my life too. What's got to go? Has got to go. Every day. Consecration through the power and the Spirit of the living God. a ser consagrados diariamente. Because I sure don't want to end up in the refrigerator. The relationship is so, starts to get cold, and all of a sudden it doesn't feel like nothing anymore. And you know, we got a generation out there right now. Tenemos una generación que cree en Dios, pero no le sirven a Dios. We have a generation that believes in God, but is not willing to live in for God.
That's right.
There's a high percentage, even within churches in general. Then we wonder when situations start to happen. Well, guess what's happening? We go in one door, then we come out, we jump on the old camel and head back to Egypt for the rest of the week. I like to use that example. I tell this to the men, I tell it to myself. Yeah, every day I say, God, show me, reveal yourself. Because guess what happened to many out there? Mira lo que le ha ocurrido a muchos. Como brincaron en el camello y se fueron en, perdón, Egipto. That old camel gave up in the middle of the desert. Where's Joe? We haven't seen him in a long time. That old camel gave up in the middle of the desert. He didn't make it back. La rebelión causa problemas. The rebellion and rejection. In the moment we just slow down. See, when God is doing that beauty for ashes and the oil of joy for mourning, oh, it's a beautiful process. It's a therapy that we need right now. All over. That's why the enemy has gained a lot of ground all over this region, but there's power in the blood. We move on and we get into warfare, we pray, we fast, and we pray for the region that the strongholds be broken.
Yes, amen.
Que las ataduras de Satanás sean quebradas, todas las maldiciones and the curse over the land, the strongholds of witchcraft and idolatry and everything else that doesn't conform to the will of God. Todo lo que no le agrada a Dios. See, in this transformation process, the beauty for ashes, he's calling out the leadership as well and saying, no. My words, my thinking, my flow of the Spirit, all those opinions are just nothing to me. And it's really awesome. It is really awesome. And he'll change the message. He'll change the order of the service the moment he wants to.
Yes.
Él cambia la orden de servicio para que haya liberación. That there be deliverance, that a word of prophecy will flow, that lives will be blessed. And boy, we need those blessings right now.
Yes.
We really need them. We really need them so much. You know, a lot of us know and hear the news about this opioid epidemic and meth and this and that and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, we're going to have to reach out to get some more ammunition to the Word of God. We're going to have to flow in the Spirit even more and say, Almighty God, anoint me with a fresh anointing.
Yes.
Like fresh fire.
Yes.
For such a time as this. Úngeme, Señor, para el tiempo como hoy. In the libro de los Salmos, in the book of Psalms, chapter 91, and verse 1. Oh, praise God for the whole Bible and the book of Psalms. I'll tell you, there's so much therapy in His Word, in the book of Psalms, and
yes,
so much of an admonition right there.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah to the Spirit of to the living God in every way. Capítulo 91 de los Salmos y versículo 1, chapter 91 and verse 1. This is what it's going to take every day. This is what es lo que se lleva diariamente. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yeah.
And I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust.
Yes.
Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
Yes.
Dice que habita el abrigo del Altísimo, morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Diría Jehová, esperanza mía y castillo mío, mi Dios en quien confiaré. Él te librará del lazo del cazador, de la peste destructora. Ahí encontramos la salvación en esa cobertura, en la palabra del Espíritu de Él. See, there's a plan of salvation all over the Word of God. And right here in Psalms 91, it's right there in the secret place of the Most High. In His hedge of protection for such a time as this, that He may teach us, that He may reveal Himself to us in a mighty way.
Yes.
You know how the church is going to have an impact? How are we going to have an impact individually and corporately every day? to overflow in the Spirit of God. Que sobreabunde que tenemos en él, dice, yo he venido para que tengas vida y la tengas en abundancia. Says, I have come that you might have life.
Yes.
See, life in the Spirit.
Yeah.
And have it more abundantly. And that's the only way to have an impact with our kids, with our neighbors, with our families, with our co-workers. If not, they're going to run all over us. Our co-workers, oh, yeah. Okay, here I go. You know, to have an impact. Mm-hmm. See, the moment that we know about our identity in Christ, we know about the authority that we have in Him. Cuando sabemos, tenemos la identificación en Cristo, que hay esa relación con Él diariamente, creyendo y viviendo por Él, entonces ya reconocemos la autoridad que tenemos. Then we know about the authority that we have to declare and decree in the name of Jesus a hedge of protection over our children, over our lives,
yes,
over our families, over our jobs, over our marriages, over everything. Declarando y decretando, tomando autoridad diariamente, taking authority. See, he who dwells, and it goes on and says, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust.
Amen.
His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth the noonday. Right, boy, there's a lot of it out there right now.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of that stuff. You know, a lot of the lies of the enemy.
Yeah.
A lot of the doom and gloom. But then there is a power of God under His protection. And no matter what they call us, hey, you bunch of holy rollers. And there you go again. Oh, there you go. Oh, one mess of doom, man. And I tell them, yeah, hallelujah, that's all right. If we're rolling on the floor,
yes,
if we're going to be free, we're going to be blessed, then our lives are going to be blessed. Hallelujah. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Digan lo que digan o burló de los criticones, pero somos libres y somos bendecidos. Tenemos que declararlo, that we are free and that we are blessed.
Yes.
And my mother's sitting back there, and when I call her up in the morning, I said, okay, repeat this after me. And she's like, recibo las bendiciones de Dios en abundancia, de salud, de amor y de prosperidad. En este día y los días venideros. En este año y los años venideros. Estamos declarando y decretando, hablando palabras de vida. I call my mother and she's sitting back there. I call her up and say, how are you doing this morning? Okay. Repeat after me. And she's like, I receive. And she's repeating. I receive. If you want to repeat after me, feel free. I receive the blessings and the abundance of health, of love, and of prosperity this day and the days ahead.
This year
and the years ahead. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. See, we are declaring and decreeing by faith.
Yes.
If we don't declare and decree by faith, well, guess who's going to do it? Huh. Guess who else is going to do it?
Huh.
And it's not going to be good.
No. Yep.
He's going to talk defeat. He's going to talk doom and gloom.
Yes.
He's going to see. Many don't know how to respond with the trials and the struggles of the day. They don't know how to respond, and they start to go here and there and everywhere. And they, you know, I was ministering this message, another message last week. There's a spirit of hypochondria out there.
Yeah. Oh,
that's right.
A lying enemy.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
There was one city to start looking for symptoms. And all of a sudden, you look in the mirror and you say, oh, my God, am I turning into a werewolf? See, that's a lie from the pit of hell. People start to look for symptoms. Oh, my foot is hurting. You know, are they going to have to take it off completely or what? See, the enemy has a headache. And an amigo quiere que se manifieste el espíritu de apocrianda, como se capó, para las mentiras que se manifiesten. Quien de la confusión y el temor. And all of a sudden we're so distracted, we start to self-project. Oh, that's horrible. It's a dangerous area. Well, they said I've been a bum. They say I'll never be out for drugs. And maybe they're right. And well, I guess that's my destiny. Then we start to speak defeat. Es horrible. Muchos comienzan a hablar el destino, comienzan a hablar derrota, y lo viven. Once again, those words that are powerful. See, a lot of these words in that paper attract people and attract people to events. So those words gotta attract them. Those that are lost, those that are confused. It's all you blessed. I had a bumper-to-bumper situation in Austin once, and you know, it was, you know, it's like, oh my God, what happened here? You know, and everything started to, you know, said, I know all this fine. I hit a car, but you know, I didn't hit this car. I just barely tapped into it. But the third car said, oh, this or that. But I had somebody at the other end, and sometimes it's going to take relatives to say, come up with that. I'll see how you come out of this one. Getting a kick out of it. See, the enemy wants to get a kick out of this.
Yeah.
He wants to tell you, see how you come out of this one. And he gets a kick out of it. But we got to declare back, oh, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
En el nombre de Jesús tenemos que declarar y decretar, porque el enemigo está diciendo, a ver cómo sales de esa situación. See how you come out of it. Financial situation, that marital situation, whatever situation, and say, oh, I'm coming out in the name of Jesus. Because where the Spirit of God is,
yes,
there's liberty.
Yes.
Donde el Espíritu de Dios está, ahí hay libertad.
Amen.
See, but we got to come into this secret place, day in, day out. The Lord, teach me. You know, because real men pray, real women pray, real women cry, real men cry. It's all right to pour out before God.
Yes.
It's all right to, you know, I like to use the bottle expressions to take that cap off and throw it aside and empty out all that stuff that you've been filled up with. Those worldly opinions and areas of, you know, that are so negative and so hurtful. And to allow the Spirit to flow. Dejar que el Espíritu se manifieste poderosamente.
Yes.
Dice, palabra de Dios, con sus plumas te cubrirá y debajo de sus alas estarás seguro. Escudo de alarma es su verdad. No temerás el terror nocturno ni saeta que vuela de día, ni pestilencia que ande en oscuridad, ni mortandad que en medio del día destruya. Lo que no le agrada a Dios trae un ambiente que no mano. Pero gracias a Dios que Dios nos va a dar un jalón de oreja y si vámonos, no tiene negocio ahí tú.
Amen.
In those areas of darkness, those areas that, and you don't feel a certain presence, and we just praise God for this, because once again he's going to give us that pool of ears and step back. You got no business there. Only if he needs, as Brother Jose was been ministering going against the giants, only if he needs, only if the Spirit needs to go against those giants. See, he's going to give you the ammunition and cover yourself. Okay, go.
Amen.
Ven en autoridad. No más si te dije. No vayas, porque hay un murero ahí del enemigo, unas trampas del enemigo que no más no. There's some snares that the enemy has out there. That's why it's important that we be led out of the Spirit. That's why it's important that we're in that secret place for fresh revelation. And you know, the beautiful thing about it, that what's going to flow out of there, the message in prophecy.
Yes.
The message of word of knowledge and word of revelation,
yes.
Word of interpretation, discernment, discernimiento. Si lo vamos al rumbo, tal vez que no salga nada. There's going to be a lot of mambo jumbo. It's going to go, oh, get out of here. You know, praise be to God that he who dwells, that's all of us, in the secret place of the Most High.
Yes.
How beautiful. How beautiful, you know, that we should day in and day out call forth anointing like a fresh fire of his Spirit. Unción como fuego para el tiempo como hoy. Gloria a su nombre. En el libro de los Hechos, capítulo 1, versículo 7. From the book of Acts, chapter 1, and verse 7. And hallelujah, bless you, he's a mighty God. He is moving in a mighty way every day. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He's you know, he wants us to step out and jump around and go that way and under the radar and over the radar and everything else as he needs. Hallelujah, he's really, really a beautiful thing that he's doing. You know, he's not finished with us. He's telling us, this has got to go, and that has got to go, that he be glorified. The book of Acts, chapter 1, and verse 7, hallelujah. Gloria a su nombre. And I ask you for continued prayers for the message in the jail and wherever the Lord leads. Because I don't feel like getting comfortable. See, the moment that we get comfortable, that we turn conformist. And there's a lot of, there's people that God has called, and there's certain callings in your life, certain giftings, but the enemy would want to throw that fear in you and say, no, who do you think you are? Don't say a single word. Just stay there and be quiet. I had a man that's been in ministry for years, and he looked at me, and this is somebody in ministry, he had this big old smile, and he said, what have you been up to? And I could, and I had this certain smile, and like you're going to give me the same old mumbo jumbo. I said, you know what I've been up to? And we see, we have to declare a decree. And I said, there is a calling in my life, and then I refuse to shut up.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. That's the God that we serve.
Yes.
See, through the highways and hedges, around the kitchen area for you women out there, and around town and around the big mall. Everywhere.
The Alpine Mall?
Yes. All over the place. Hallelujah. And right there in the book of Acts, chapter 1 and verse 7, this is what the Word of God gives it, la palabra de Dios. He said, y me dijo, no os toca a vosotros saber los tiempos a las sazones que el Padre puso en su sola potestad. Pero recibiréis poder cuando haya venido sobre vosotros el Espíritu Santo. Y me seréis testigos en Jerusalén y en toda Judea y en Samaria hasta el último de la tierra. Y habiendo dicho estas cosas, viéndolo ellos, fui alzado y recibió una nube que les ocultó de sus ojos. Y estando ellos con los ojos puestos en el cielo, entre tanto que él iba, he aquí se pusieron junto a ellos dos varones con vestiduras blancas. Dice, los cuales también les dijeron, varones galileos, ¿por qué estáis mirando al cielo? Este mismo Jesús que ha sido tomado de vosotros al cielo, así vendrá como lo habéis visto ir al cielo. Gloria a Dios, aleluya. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power.
Yes.
But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem, at the mall, and witnesses unto both at our jobs, and everywhere in Judea, and all Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven, as if we now behold two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into the heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall also come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven. There's a beautiful thing about it, that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. When I was going to take some classes at Soros, the student invited me to go fellowship with them at their apartment, the duplex apartments that used to be on Highway 90. So I went over, and there was some word, and it was fine. You know, I said, wow, I'm glad that I came over and do some fellowship. He says, do not forsake the assembly. But then you also have to discern.
Yeah.
You also got to know it once again. Because God doesn't want to throw a bologna sandwich of a message. Here, take this. That's it. He wants to bless us in the abundance. He wants to make sure that the word is flowing with under the quality, which the quality comes through the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Not just quantity, but quality. That it would minister to our heart and to our mind and to our spirit. Que la palabra ministra nuestro cuerpo, nuestro espíritu, nuestra alma. And it's really something because, you know, and that's the only way to be able to say, oh my God, that's beautiful. Now we're not in that areas that seem to be like a refrigerator. It's like, whoa, there's a flow of spirit here. That's beautiful. And see, this is what God is doing. He wants us to be blessed for such a time as this. But he said, you shall also receive power. Mm-hmm. See, there's those areas that many have forgotten about, that power. See, the word is so powerful.
Yes.
But it can be just so much theology, not until the Holy Spirit, we allow the Holy Spirit to flow, then there is that word and spirit flowing. And the only way to have that impact is to overflow in the word and spirit.
Yes.
And not to conform that A plus B equals Z, and that's it. Hallelujah. So in closing today,
yeah.
What is it going to take? And in closing the book of Ezekiel, and it says right there, and to him be the glory. Apparently there's some tempered and untempered mortar. Mm. So we're going to have to discern for such a time as this.
Yeah.
We're going to have to ask God in all those areas, Lord, show me. There in chapter 13. Chapter 13 and verse 10. Show me, dear God. Because man has tried to put in his own little mixture of things.
Uh-huh.
And to dilute for the power of the Spirit. See, there's a beauty in the essence of the presence. So powerful. Una chuliada en la esencia de la presencia. Capítulo 10, capítulo 13, versículo 10, 13 and 10. It says right here. Si por cuanto engañaron a mi pueblo diciendo paz, no viendo paz. Y uno edificaba la pared, y aquí que los otros la recibieran con lodo suelto. Vi a los recubridores con todo lodo suelto, que caerá. Vendrá lluvia torrencial, y enviaré piedras de granizo que la hagan caer, y viento tempestuoso la romperá. Because even they have seduced my people, saying peace, and there was no peace. And one built up a wall, and no others daubed it with untempered mortar. Say unto them which daub it with untempered mortar, that it shall fall, and shall be an overflowing shower. O ye great hailstones shall fall, and a stormy wind shall rend it. Lo, when the wall is fallen, shall it not be said unto you, where is the daubing wherewith you have daubed it? And in closing right now, there's a very important, it's an in-depth message. I don't have time this morning, but the message of the tempered and untempered mortar, that God would give us discernment. Because when all these other wall ideas start to come in that don't conform to the will of God, that mixture brings a confusion. And who's the author of all confusion? The enemy.
Yes.
So when we pray this morning, we allow the Spirit to move. Today, tomorrow, the day and the days ahead, the years ahead, that he would give us fresh revelation. And anything that is a mixture of man, anything from a religious perspective, not aligned with the Spirit of the living God.
Mm.
Why? Because there's people that are bound right now. And still bound. Bound in those other ideas, the isms.
Mm-hmm.
All these concepts. Between a tempered and untempered mortar. Es mucho que se han mezclado. Y vamos a orar esta mañana. Si hay algo que se han mezclado en nuestras vidas, if there's something that is coming as a mixture in our lives, in our homes, because somebody said that it looks good, feels good, sounds good, I'll take it. But God is saying, wait a minute. It's not even of me. See, it's impulse buying.
Yes.
We can't afford to follow that. We better have discernment. And in closing today, as we take a deeper dive into the essence of the presence, the beauty of the Spirit, is going to be that flow of Spirit that anoints you like fresh fire. And he's going to call out your gifting. Tu llamamiento te lo va a decir, mira, te necesito. I need you. I need you out there. I need you to minister. It's not about me. It's just, there's disciples. It's about him. Well, I need you out there. Te necesito. We got a math problem, we got a this problem and that problem, we got a problem of rebellion and rejection right now.
Yes.
Problema de rebelión y rechazo. Que Dios nos bendiga ricamente porque Dios quiere que lo levantemos. That we be raised and be ready to engage. These are the rules of engagement.
Yes.
Into the Spirit of God.
Yes.
No matter if we have to step in Joel's toes. That's all right to step on his toes and say, hey, you know, like give us an analogy.
Yes.
Es un ejemplo nomás. Y si necesitas de Dios, vamos a orar. I want to thank you for the invitation. I want to ask you your prayers for me for the jail ministry. I'm going to ask for your prayers for my daughter, which I'm going to take to Odessa this week. And, you know, as I mentioned earlier, raised my two daughters as a single parent, not to see her go for 6 years in the Air Force. It's not an easy ride for me, but I got to move from fear to faith every day. And I just ask for your prayers for me in the ministry and what God has in store for my other daughter and two sons and her husband. Because God knows every need that we have,
yes, he does.
Even the desires of our heart.
That's right.
But most of all, we allow the Spirit to flow.
Yes.
And that way, it makes things much more beautiful, the essence of the Spirit, la esencia de la presencia. Dios bendiga ricamente. God bless you. I want to thank Pastor Jose. Excuse me, Pastor Jose, and Patricia, and all of you for allowing me to speak. But feel free to give me a spiritual punch if I get out of line. A word of exhortation, because I don't know at all. Feel free, but I'll just go out there in the back room and you can just go. No. Thank you so much, and God bless you, and I'm going to ask you. And I'm going to ask Mr. Jose and Patricia, they want to pray for me or pray for the